600,000 votes are left to be counted and distributed in the state of Arizona, right? Of those 600,000, 420,000 of them are in Maricopa County. There it is. So of those 420,000 that are left to count in Maricopa County, we now know at 7 o'clock Arizona time tonight, we'll get a lot of them counted and the results released. And that's going to happen in 38 minutes. So 38 minutes from now, we may have some real clarity on Arizona. And then they'll release more of those ballots, those vote totals, at 10:30 Arizona time. So midnight and a half on the East Coast. Let's turn to the NBC national political reporter, Sahil Kapoor, who's live with us tonight. Sahil, this all seems disjointed and a little helter-skelter and stuff, but the truth is it's pretty orderly. They're counting, they're taking their time doing it, and then they're going to release the result. It's just not really on our time frame. It's on a reality time frame.
That's right, Shep. It's exactly what we expected. Arizona, like in the 2018 election, takes time to count. We already knew this. Now there's a pandemic. The mail-in vote is much bigger than it usually is. They're taking a little extra time to count. We were prepared for this from the start, and nobody should be surprised with it. Your point, Shep, about Maricopa, it's so crucial because the fact that Joe Biden is leading by some 5 or 6 points there, that appears to be the key for why he is in good shape to win that state. NBC News has not called it. We're waiting for that remaining vote. But based on the numbers you displayed, if that trend continues, Joe Biden is going to win Arizona, and that's going to put him just about 6 electoral votes from victory. Maricopa County, the Phoenix and the suburbs around there, that used to be a Republican stronghold. Donald Trump won that county by 3 points, about 3 points in 2016, and it's one of the reasons that Republicans have so dominated Arizona. That has now trended away from the Republicans. That has moved toward Democrats, like so many of the suburbs and metro areas around the country. And that's one of the reasons we're seeing this kind of realignment.
And to your point, if we get a big drop from Maricopa County, which we think we're going to do, we think that because the elections official just told NBC News that. And if we get enough of them, it's possible that there could be a decision on Arizona, a decision that, you know, some have made that we've not made because we don't know the details and we'd rather be right than first. But at any rate, let's talk about the path to 270. You mentioned if Joe Biden gets Arizona, his path becomes clearer, right? Walk us through that if you could.
Sure. So his path involves Arizona seems to be a likely state that falls in his column. Again, I want to emphasize it has not been called yet, but he is ahead there. And the remaining votes seem to come from places like Maricopa County predominantly that are friendly to him. If he wins Arizona, then he needs one state, one more state, and he is currently leading in Nevada. He is trailing in Georgia, but there are still a vote, you know, more votes, more and more votes coming in that are bringing Joe Biden closer to Trump. Last I checked, just about 15 minutes ago, he was within a point away, just about 40,000 votes down out of millions cast in Georgia. There's also Pennsylvania, where Trump is considerably ahead at the moment, but there's a lot of vote coming in places like Philadelphia County and Democratic areas, you know, big counties that are slow to count votes or a lot of mail-in votes that the state was not able to count until very close or right around, you know, the morning of Election Day. So that is going to be trending in Joe Biden's favor. Whether it's enough to put him over the top remains to be seen. But the bottom line, Shep, if Joe Biden wins Arizona, he just needs one more state and he's going to be the next president of the United States.
No question. But the fact remains, there is absolutely, without question, a path for Donald Trump to be reelected. Walk us through that if you could.
The path for Donald Trump to be reelected looks something like this. He's got to hold on in Georgia. He cannot afford to lose that state with the final vote coming in. It's not clear that he is going to fall behind there, but there's a possibility. He cannot afford to let that happen. North Carolina, our colleague just walked us through the remaining vote coming in. Trump is winning North Carolina by somewhere between 70 and 80,000 votes. Our colleague mentioned that there were about 100,000 votes to come in. That seems to be a pretty comfortable margin. He would have to lose that final vote by a massive, massive margin to fall behind in North Carolina. So that state looks pretty good for President Trump. From there, things get very complicated because he's already lost Michigan and Wisconsin. He's not going to you know, continue to kind of trample over that part of the blue wall. He has to win Pennsylvania. There is no path for President Trump at this point without Pennsylvania. There is a path for Joe Biden without Pennsylvania. All that talk about Pennsylvania, 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 that mm-hmm. state being the decisive force potentially in this election, it is very true for President Trump at this moment. And that's one of the reasons you see his campaign, you know, kind of jumping in there with lawsuits, making claims that are faulty or unsubstantiated about voter fraud. No evidence for that, but he is making that argument in an attempt to stop counting votes at this point.
Yeah.
Shepard Smith here. Thanks for watching CNBC on YouTube.